So your question is, should we have expectation in life? Definitely you have to have expectation. A person who is a student who is studying, he should have an expectation that he will get 100 marks. Okay. So this having expectation and attaching to the result, they are very different. Shri Krishna said in Bhagavad Gita, karmanne vadhikaraste ma phaleshu kadachana. You have to do karma, you have right to do karma, and you have ability to do karma. And while doing karma, you should know that you have to achieve something. You should have expectation. But he said, ma phaleshu kadachana. Don't get attached to the results. Okay? Because whatever we do, we have expectation. I should get 100 marks. So he got 95 marks. Should he commit suicide? He failed. Should he commit suicide? Now, doing good effort for writing exam and passing the exam is what he can do. It's under his control. But the result is not under his control. The examiner is not under control. Paper is not under his control. For everything which is under control, there are million things which are not under my control, which is called under the control of the universe. You can say God. The phala is not under your control. Okay? So Krishna didn't say don't get have expectation. You have to have a perfect expectation. You need to know perfect focus. You need to have a perfect goal while doing karma. But never get attached to the result. The result should be like this only. I have to get 100 marks only. If I get 1 mark less, I commit suicide. Is that good for you? Okay, I accept whatever result. I do my best. Then whatever result comes, even if I fail, I do my best. So this is the attitude you should have. There are many things in life, or everything in life, result is not under our control. Result is depend on the universe. It may be depend on my karma, it may be my past karma, it may be depend on the external circumstances. So we should know what is under my control, what is not under my control. What is not under my control, I just accept what should come. But what happens is most of the people, they put less effort for what is under their control. And what is not under their control, they keep on worrying about that. Shri Krishna said, forget what is not under your control, leave it. Whatever comes, accept it as a gift from God, grace from God. In fact, good comes or bad comes, you can use it for your evolution. Okay? Focus on your action. Then what happens? You become better and better in your action. Then your chance of getting great results also increases. This is called karma yoga. Okay? So don't confuse expectation and attachment to result. They are different. Very different. Are you clear? So what is the question now?
No. My question was, The expectation starts when there is an attachment.
No.
If there is no attachment,
so what is expectation starts with an attachment, you said. What is this attachment business? I tell you. What is attachment? What do you mean by attachment?
Attachment with my son.
So attachment with my son. Okay. Let us say you have an attachment with your son. Okay, then what is the expectation?
Naturally he should be good, he should
okay, naturally he should be studying well and study good. Okay.
Be a good human being.
Be good a human being. So, expectation is, attachment comes in the expectation come do together. No. Expectation and role goes together. Expectation and attachment don't go together. So, you have a role as a mother. Okay. That's all you have. So, and you have to take care of a son. Okay. As the role of mother, what are the few things which you can do? You can provide him good food. You can provide him time. You can provide him education. You can help him education. That's your role and that's what you can do. Right? What is the expectation? My son should be good. He should study well. He should get a good rank. Okay? Whatever is that. So there is a work which you can do. There's an a role you can perform. And there is a result you can expect. It's perfectly natural to expect the result. It's nothing because of attachment. It's because of your role. Okay. If you are mother, you have a certain role to play and certain expectation for that. If you are daughter-in-law, there's a role to play and there's a certain expectation for that. It's role. It's not attachment. It's not because of my son. It's because of your role to play in Israel. Like, role to play, the responsibility is you. What action I can do. Now, in these expectations, yes, you can do your best. When I say you can do your best, always we have a limitation in life. If I can do my best, I can be the president of this country. But I cannot. There are certain limitations. If I can do best, I can run an Olympics race. They're all imagination. Each of us can do best in a given circumstance. There's a given limitation. We are not free in that sense. We have a lot of boundaries, visible and invisible. Within that boundary, can I do my best? And if you are able to do best with the expectation that this has to happen, then that expectation may happen or may not happen. You don't have a control over the result. You have a control over your action. With the best of your intentions, some may fail in the examination. Or some may not score good marks. Then how do you take the result? You feel bad?
Naturally
you feel bad? I don't.
So
it is not attachment.
Okay, then if you are convinced you have done your best, okay, still he fails, then you can say, okay, you can apply, but because of that small thing attachment, you
see, this attachment is an illusionary word for you. We'll find out what is attachment.
Otherwise, why you feel bad?
No, I'm saying, I'll try to understand. This attachment is an illusory word. My daughter, when she was young, she had a health issues, difficulties, when she was in 5th standard. And everybody used to tease her because she is short and lean. Okay? Everybody used to tease her. She was not able to perform in the school because of the inferiority complex. Her marks is always less. Failed sometimes. Not a single day I shouted at her. So she comes with a failed marks card. I congratulate her and distribute sweets. Okay, say, I'm sure you'll do well next time. So, and this continued for 3-4 years. Then she regained her health. By the time she came to SLC, she regained her health and she did well in SLC. If I had put down her in any other stage earlier, she will never cross SSLC. That was the situation. Okay. So, I have to see whether she has done her best, whether I have done my best. Then beyond that, results are in God's hand. Her health can't do anything. So, we have to see where is our limitation. We cannot make the fire become cold because I want it. We have to accept nature as it is. Okay. See, have you heard of any time somebody complaining the fire is hot? No. Why? The fire burning is nature. Can anybody say it, can you say, have you seen anybody cursing this snake? Okay. Or cursing the tiger? It's a cruel animal. This is nature. Everything has inherent nature. Okay. So it will behave according to that. So now when something is behaving according to nature, we'll never curse. But when my husband, when my son, when they are behaving according to nature, we start cursing. We start feeling bad about it. Why?
Because
we think that person has the ability to change. He is not changing. You understand? Mm-hmm. We expect a certain changed behavior from that person, thinking that he has the ability to change. Okay? And we expect the change has to happen according to my wishes. Okay. Is it not similar to expecting the fire to turn cold? The person has the ability to change, but only when the desire comes from inside. Okay. Because you want the person to change, nobody will change. Because he wants to change, the change will come internally. So, if the change for the desire for change has not come from internally, no matter how hard you curse, no matter how hard you abuse, that change will not happen. It will, in fact, it will aggravate the situation. In the process, what will happen? You feel bad. See, what's happening is we want to dictate to nature. See, the person is also part of the nature. Okay? We look like the human body, but he is a part of the nature. He is actually going exactly by nature. That's called Swabhava. His nature, he cannot change. Unless the desire for the change comes from inside. From external conditions, we can only give trigger. But we should not, we cannot feel bad. We cannot curse that person. We cannot feel abuse that person. Okay? Because he is not changing. I told you today, example of the situation. Somebody tries to cheat me. I don't have any hatred or jealousy or anger for that person. I know it's simply it's his nature. He is not able to overcome that nature. I only wish that, yeah, if he wants, can I help him? That's all I can say. The change has to happen from within. But we start feeling frustrated. We feel angry, not because of attachment. Please understand. We want to change the nature. It's not attachment. Attachment is the name you are giving. In reality, you want to change the nature. You want to make the fire to become cold. You want the snake to be not poisonous. That's against nature. A human being has the ability to change. But only if the desire for change comes within, not from external pressures. External mean our wishes. So we feel frustrated when our wishes are not getting fulfilled. Actually, this is going beyond our limits. What we can ask is, am I doing my best for a given situation? That's all. And rest of things, if you leave God, things will heal themselves. Things will change themselves. Right now, what we do is, we are trying to dictate to God what he has to do and forgetting what we have to do. No. See, it's like Arjuna and Krishna are sitting in the chariot. Krishna is driving the vehicle and Arjuna is supposed to fight the war. If Arjuna says, Krishna, you fight the war, okay, I will watch. This is ulta. Right now, what we want is, we want God to take care of certain situations in life. Okay? We want nature to be changed. And we get frustrated. Nature is not changing. Then we give so many names to that. It's because of my attachment, because of my husband, because of my son. We give some names. It's all an illusion. Basically, you want to change the nature. How it will happen? Nature is nature. The change will happen. A snake cannot become poisonless. Fire cannot become cold. But human being can change. But provided the change, desire for change come from inside. Not from. But you start reacting. That only strengthens the behavior. So,
in this context, that's why there is a question on expectation. Like many times I feel that surrender is the best way to, like, whatever is happening, surrender to that, so that you don't have any, like when I said expectation, it was from that perspective. Instead of expecting, okay, things will change.
Instead
of expecting, so is it the best way? Because many times I feel that's the best way I should be, but I can't. Okay, there is a duality, and yeah, it happened because some introspection happens. I come for the class, I realize I'm not the body, mind, all this. Still, but in such situations, I'm not able to even think properly, or first thing is I am, then all this, and then is it the surrender is the best way to?
What do you mean by surrender?
Whatever is happening. It has to happen like this, so it's happening.
No, what
so
is?
Don't have any expectation.
So, expectation is not on somebody. Expectation is not something. Expectation is what I want to do and what is the result I have to get. It's about my action. It's respect to my action. I cannot expect the fire to be cold. It's not. Mm. It's not possible. I can expect this is the particular five things I am doing. This is the result. Let's say I am cleaning the house. The house has to be clean. That's the expectation. Expectation is always with respect to my action and my result which I get.
Okay. You said the cleaning. Okay. You are cleaning. Somebody keeps coming and making dirt in that. You are continuing to clean and dirt. So what is your control on that?
So then you have to ask the situation. Ask the question. This situation is not acceptable. Somebody is coming and somebody is dirtying. Okay. So situation solution number one. You have to try all of them. Warn the person. Still it's working. Solution number two, take a stick and beat the person. No. Okay. Right? Situation number three, shout at the person. So all the three is over. Then
no, you get frustrated because it's by chance. You
might no. That's what I'm trying to tell you. Don't get frustrated.
Stop.
So 1, 2, 3 you have tried. Is there any fourth action possible? So actually expectation also with respect to actions.
Call police.
Call police. Okay. So some of these, see, we have to convert our internal fear and anxiety into action. These are the four actions you have done. Still things are not working out. Okay. Then what you do? Then you have to find out, is there alternative way of doing this? Possibly. Okay. That also doesn't work. Then just accept it. So accept it, and don't accept is not resignation. In this situation is happening in my life, is there some reason for that to happen in my life? Is it pointing to some evolution in me which I can work? Okay. As you start working on that evolution, this outer situation will disappear. I have given a situation story to you. That's called Zero Limit. I don't know whether you heard of it. There's a book called Zero Limit. A psychiatrist was posted to one of the prisons in South America. It was very, very horrible prison where the patients, war veterans, were put, and they're all psychiatric patients, and they're very, very violent. They kill the doctor who comes there. No doctor stays there. So they were all chained with heavy chains. So there were about 200 patients there. This person, seeing the situation, he was horrified. He wanted to, felt like running away. He's not able to go to the ward and talk to the patient also. They will come and hit you. So then he said, okay, this must be my bad karma. I am coming here. So then he started a meditation practice called Ho'oponopono. It's a Hawaiian meditation practice, Ho'oponopono. Okay, which is actually healing his karma. As he started healing his karma, in about 1.5 to 2 years, the whole prison got empty. There were no prisoners who were left. Everybody got healed and went away. This book is a small book called Zero Limit. So any situation outside what we experience is nothing but our inner reflection. Okay. So there is a message for you in that. There is something which you need to correct inside you. Have you listened to the message? The situation outside is causing irritation. It's causing pain. But irritation and pain is coming for evolution of you. It's like an alarm clock ringing, trying to wake you up. Have you woken up to that inner reality? The moment you start waking up to the inner reality, outer situation vanishes from your life, because outer and inner are just concepts. There are no outer and inner. In your dream, you saw a nightmare. A ghost came. Was there a ghost? You try to run away from the ghost. The ghost is chasing you. There's no ghost. It is you. The outer situation is reflection of your inner situation. Have you noticed that? Are you able to work on that? That's why the outer situation keeps coming.
But I'll tell you, because this is almost a, so 13 years with you. So this happens, and I start like feeling that, because even when I react now, the next moment I'm getting that awareness, and many times I go back and even say sorry so that I reacted. And that happens, the situation changes. Situation changes. It's not that the same situation throughout life. It's almost like their nature changing. But this has become more like a cycle.
No.
That's when I...
This whole concept...
That's when now I'm started looking at so many other aspects, whether it's because of my expectation that I feel that...
See, the expectation I've clarified. What is the expectation is you do your work, follow the expectation. It's not about the behavior of somebody. So, you see, the words we are using are confusing. So, expectation that this lady has to behave like something like that is not a correct expectation. Expectation, I do this and this result is expectation. If somebody else's behavior is not my expectation. Somebody's behavior, okay, you can warn, you can do, but that's not about expectation. So, you don't use the word expectation, attachment wrongly. Then you will confuse them. Surrender also is not wrongly. Surrender doesn't mean that I'll resign. Okay, I'm helpless. No. Surrender means this situation has something for me to evolve. Something is teaching me. Am I able to do that? So I'll tell you, if you have really addressed your inner issue, the outer issues will vanish. I can give in writing. And this is my experience. As we address inner, the outer will vanish. As the person is seeing nightmare every day in and day out, the nightmare is not in the dream. It's in his mind. As he's addressed, the nightmare will vanish. It will be replaced.
Avoiding that situation, or say walking out of that situation, would be an easier option.
No, see, there are some possibilities. There are some situations in life we can walk away. Okay, we can avoid. There are same situations, we cannot walk away. Okay? Suppose, I'm saying married, you are married to husband and wife. In America, they will take a divorce. In India, the divorce is not common. Okay? So, divorce they take, but what will happen doesn't give a solution. There's some problem in between these two. Now, this problem gets carried forward to next marriage. It is not giving any solution. We are not addressing it. In India, divorce may not be a solution. And you have to face the situation day in and day out. You cannot avoid it. But that situation, you can take it for evolution, I'm saying. I'm telling you, it is coming for your good. Are you able to recognize that? Okay, if you are able to recognize that, your mind will be so silent and peaceful and serene that the situation will change. Your outer situation is a reflection of your inner situation. There's nothing outer and inner. In your dream, you saw a ghost, which is outside. But the ghost was in your mind. And this, in the waking condition, what you see as outer and inner, it's only conceptual, not real. What you see in outer is your inner situation that has come for your evolution. The ghost in your dream has not come to you scare you. Ghost in your dream has come to you tell you that this is there in your mind. Get out of it. It's not possible. Some situations, yes, we can avoid. See, it's like this. There are situations in life. Okay. Some situations you have to confront because it will give a solution. Some situations in life, you can don't have to confront. You just walk away. Some situations you have to face then and there out loud. For example, let's say, I am going to a situation where I have to government office to get some work done. Now, that guy asks a bribe. So, it's not a good thing. I can fight that fellow. I can shout at the fellow. I can go to the court. But then in the process, I am losing time. I don't have time. The time I can use it for something else. So, pay that fellow and get rid of it or get out of it. Maybe it's not the right thing. But I don't have enough time and the time available is short. I can use it for something else. So, you have to give a value. By doing this, something can happen. What is the benefit? Right? So, what I'm saying is, yeah, you have to take a judgment call. But what I'm saying is, if the very simple rule of life, what you resist persists. If there's a resistance arising in you, it persists in your life until you learn from that. The learning is non-resistance. Non-resistance is not meek acceptance. By not resisting, how I can go to myself and recognize myself. As I may recognize myself, the outer will change in a better way. So, whenever you use the word attachment, okay, or expectation, without understanding we are using the word, that itself causes a bigger chakra, maya. Okay. Any small word we use without clarity, that word itself starts cluttering the mind. Be careful about the word you choose. And the word which you choose becomes our maya, our illusion. Everything in your life, all circumstances in your life are pointing to the self. As you move towards the self, the outer situation eases. The outer is a reflection of the inner. This you understand. The more you resist, it will persist. The avoid, the situation isn't solved. It will appear in some other way. The question is, can I do something by confronting the situation? Do I have enough time and bandwidth? Is what you have to see. Otherwise, you just walk away, expecting that the situation will come from somewhere else. Fine. But there are some situations in life, keep on persisting. Okay? There will be pattern in that. Okay? The pattern is, example, you. So, somebody has a problem with the relationship. Okay? Now, either you walk away from this relationship or break from this relationship or continue the relationship. Unless you resolve internally, the relationship problem will come to somebody else. Okay? It will persist. Many lifetimes it will persist. The problem is not outer. The problem is the inner.
Huh? There's a block in
us. I would say, yes, you have to look at inner. Ultimately, you have to recognize your true nature. Read that book, Zero Limit. It's a nice book, small book. It's available in the PDF form on the internet. Yeah, you're done? Let me stop this.